Database. You've heard the term before, but really, what is it? A database is simply an organized collection of information that can be retrieved. Have you ever used Amazon.com to shop? If you answered yes, then you've used a database. Amazon.com uses the same functionality that our library databases use. You have a need, let's say women's shoes that are black, size 9, and from 9 West. On Amazon, you check off those components on the sidebar and Amazon retrieves only those results. When you use a library database, you're essentially going through the same process. You have a need, let's say scholarly articles from 2010 to 2015 on the subject of organic farming in the United States. Once you select a database to search in, you'll want to type in your keywords. So in our example, we would type in organic farming and United States. We would limit the date range to 2010 to 2015 and select scholarly or peer-reviewed articles. Not so scary, right? And remember, our databases aren't just limited to print formats like articles, newspapers, and reports. Some of them focus on very specific formats, like collections of streaming videos, maps, art images, statistics, business data, and more. While some of the databases, like JSTOR, Science Direct, and Academic Search Complete, are ideal for searching across disciplines, some of them focus on specific subject areas. For example, Psych Articles and Psych Info are databases that cover only psychology journals. Keep in mind that your tuition helps pay for access to these databases that cover the major subjects taught at Roger Williams University. The vast majority of this material is not available on the open web. So if you were just planning on using Google to find your articles, think again. Need help searching in a database? Ask a librarian. We're always happy to help you with your work. Created using Powtoon.